guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Ambichini Wala and we are on the 6th episode of Anyone Can Learn. First of all, I would really like to thank you guys for showing so much of love to me on this series of mine. I'm really, really glad that you guys are enjoying it, learning so much from it. So today I decided to do the most asked topic till now, which is the brushes. We're gonna do all about brushes, so I'm really, really excited and I hope you guys like this video as much. So yeah, what we're gonna learn about brushes today is how to use them, how you can clean them, how to take care of them, and what are the brushes that you will require. So I'm gonna be telling you a lot of things, so get ready for like tremendous amount of knowledge. So yeah, without wasting further time, let's just get right into it. So when you start building your brush set, there are a few things that you need to remember. Okay, there are three rules that you need to remember. One is that we have natural bristles and we have synthetic bristles. Natural bristles is your real hair, like brushes like these. So they are dual tone. They are more softer than your synthetic brushes and they are all used for only cream products. So this is very important. And then you have your synthetic bristles. These are slightly coarser, but they are used for all powder products. This is the first rule. So real hair goes for creams and synthetic bristles goes for powder products. The second rule that you need to remember is when you pick out two brushes, you'll always find one is a round brush like this and one is a flat brush. So round brushes are used for blending purposes and flat brushes are used for application purposes. You know, so whenever you want to apply something, you apply it with a flat brush like that, and then when you want to blend something, you go ahead and you blend it with the round brush, and that goes for the entire face. The third rule that you need to remember while using your brushes is that the bigger the area, the bigger the brush, the smaller the area, the smaller the brush. So now I'm gonna show you first five brushes that you need to have for your kit to start. And these are the five brushes that are very versatile, so that you can use it for creating plenty of looks. And then I'm gonna show you a bigger version of the kit. Now, similarly, I have three buckets like these for brushes. So I have plenty of brushes, but they are quite repetitive because I've saved up all the brushes that I could. So unless and until it's broken, the hair is gone, I don't throw it away. So yeah, I have plenty of them, but you don't actually require that many brushes. You require a basic set of 5 to 10 or 12 brushes. So that is what I'm going to show you. So if you're a beginner and you're looking for the first very basic investment in brushes, then I'm going to show you 5 of them that you can, you know, build your kit on. So the first one is somewhat like this. So these sort of brushes, there are blending brushes, or you can call them polishing brushes. So these two are, this one is PAC 281 and this one is ProArt AK38. So these two brands I really, really absolutely love when it comes to brushes. One is PAC, PSC, and one is ProArt. So yeah, you can absolutely go for these brushes. Now what they will help in, you can obviously apply a foundation, but you need an absolutely good blending brush for your foundation. These are very thick in density wise, so they really help in good blending. So this is one brush, you can have any of them is fine. The second brush that you should have is something like this. These are synthetic bristles. This is called a round brush. This is a powder brush if you call it that way. So one you get is round this way and the other one has slightly this sort of shape, slightly oval shape. Any one works just fine. So this one is Makeup Studio. I don't have the number on this, but this one is PAC 134. So you can use any of this brush, or you can, you know, even use something like this, but this will be just for one purpose or two. So I would recommend to go for a slightly smaller size because it will help you apply powder, contour, highlight and blush. So this is quite versatile here. So I can go in for the powder like that. I can apply my blush, I can, because it's slightly oval, I can do my contour with it. For highlight also, I can use it here. So yeah, this is pretty versatile, so I would recommend to have this for the second one. For the third one, I would recommend you to have, so I have plenty of them, you don't need that many of them. So these are round brushes basically, these are eyeshadow round brushes or blending brushes for eyes. So I would really recommend you to go and pick out this one, that is PSE 107, because it's an oval shape again. So it is slightly flatter but round at the same time. So this is a very, very versatile brush, because since it has a flat side, I use it to even apply my eyeshadow at times, and because of the ovalness on this, I can even blend it, and it's the perfect size. So the fourth brush that I would absolutely recommend for you to have is an angular brush like this, or you can even go for a brush that is like that. So this is mainly used for much more detailing purposes, like for, you know, eyeliner, or if you want to add some other color to it, for soft lining, for much more defining, for double wing liners, whatnot. So if you want to create something else, like maybe, you know, extra molds that you want to create, so for all of that, this is very good. Especially this one I would recommend, because you can also fill in your brows with this. So an angular brush is really useful in case you are not comfortable with an angular brush for your liners. That is when I recommend you to have a brush like that, so that way it can help. So this one is PSE 1314. This is an angular brush that is useful for a lot of purposes, so eye defining brush. For the fifth brush, you can have two options. That is, one, you can have a lipstick brush, something like that, or you can have a fan brush. If you are used to using your liquid lipsticks and you don't need a liquid lipstick brush, then you can skip this and you can use a fan brush. In case if you want, you can buy a lipstick brush if you have the sticks. So yeah, if you're looking for a lipstick brush, it's PSE 361. That is very good. Fan brushes are really good because, one, they will help you highlight. Second, they will, you know, help remove anything excess on the face. So if I have excess powder here, so it'll help me get rid of that. If I want to blend in something, it will really help with blending in other things. So yeah, you can, the fifth brush that you can invest in is PAC 179. So polishing brush, powder brush, eyeshadow brush, eye defining brush, and a fan brush. A fan brush substitute is a lipstick brush. So yeah, these are the first basic five brushes that you can start your kit with. So the next set of brushes that you can absolutely have in your kit are very basic, very simple brushes that you can add on to enhance your kit. So the first one that I would suggest you is a concealer brush like this. It's a dual tone brush. It's a natural bristle brush. This will help, you know, in getting in your corrector, your concealer in, or any patchwork that you want to do, anything like that, like smaller areas that you want to get into, or on the eyelid. So this is very helpful. So it's a concealer brush that you can use. This is PAC 317. So these are contour brushes that you can have in your kit. This is a natural bristles brush, so which can be used for cream contouring purposes. This is an absolute goodness brush because it really goes exactly in the area, doesn't, you know, spread along other areas a lot. This is PAC 378. And these two are powder brushes, again same angular. So when you're using an angular brush like this, the top goes here, the top goes on the top and the bottom goes on the bottom. So whenever you apply, you go this way. The moment you go this, you'll create a patch here. So you go like, this. Yeah, so that's the use of contour brush that you can have. A round brush like this, which really helps, you know, collect the product and really helps placing the product where I need it. And because, again, the same thing, I can slightly blend it wherever I want, I can place it wherever I want. So you can use your brushes either straight like that, so to blend it, or you can even use them like that to have a flatter side. So whenever you apply a product much more on the flat layer, it really enhances and brings out the metallic effect of the product. So this I use for highlighting whenever, in case I don't want to use a fan brush because I want much more detailed product on my face. I don't have a number or a name for this brush because it's a very, very old brush, but yeah, it looks something like this. So in case if you find a brush like this, you can obviously, you know, go for it. The next brush that you can have in your kit is something like this. It's a flat brush. It's a synthetic brush. It's used for eyes. So you use a flat brush to apply the product and to press in the product, basically. This is same. All my brushes are mainly from PAC or ProArt. This is PAC 084. The next brush that you need to have is the spooky brush. We all know this brush is super helpful. This is PAC 322. But with this, you can do your brows, obviously. So there are two types of brushes. This is a much more smaller size and this is slightly bigger. So you can use any of them. You can have both of them if you want to give it much more definition. So these are really helpful in, you know, getting into the corners of the eye and maybe under eyes, so soft lining. You can even apply, you can even get like a nice crease line with the help of these brushes. This is a very, very nice defining brush. So you can do that. So yeah, round brushes, like smaller round brushes for much more detailing basically. So even this is an extra add-on brush that you can keep, which is very, very handy because there are times, you know, when you want to go really in and create a very, very thin line or give a lot of definitions or for face art basically. So yeah, these really help. Now, as I'm telling you that you don't need a lot of brushes and, you know, you don't need so many brushes, and I've showed you there's so many several uses. Like, for example, I just told you that you can use this brush for contour, for highlight and for blush. But how do you do it, okay? So, because this is a synthetic brush, it can, and you're using powder product on it, it doesn't really stick on a lot. So, what you can do is, after you're done, you can just take a dry tissue or a dry cotton pad and you can just waver it like that, so it takes away all the excess product. This is for blush, highlight and contour. So you can obviously add contour and then you can add blush and then you can just clean it off and then do a little bit of highlighting with this. So this is how you can use it, by just rubbing it off on cotton pad. Now what if I am doing liner and my lipstick together? So in case if I'm doing my liner and lipstick with the same brush, that is for example my this brush. So as you can already see, I have done liner on this, so it has that black edge. But the best part is you can use cotton pad and you can use a little bit of your cleanser, get a hint of your cleanser, like very little product, and you can immediately, you know, swipe and clean it. So as you can see, I'm cleaning it, so all the product. So once you get it out, since it has a little oil in it, I would recommend you to dry it also once. So yeah, now it's product free, and because it doesn't even have an excess oil, I can go ahead with the lip, or I can use it for, you know, adding different liners. I don't need a different brush for every single liner I do. I can just use the same one but clean it quickly like that. Is with oil, you can use just a plain micellar water. You can just use that one. So I don't know what's wrong, micellar water. Without the oil, so that will really, so you won't have to waste that extra time drying it off also. Now the main thing, how do you make your brushes last so long, is there is a cleaning process, there's a cleaning bit that you need to follow. Now this is very, very important because your brushes need to be cleaned, and so they will have a much more longer lifespan and the bristles will also, you know, stay soft. Now the important part is, whenever you take your brush for cleaning, you do not wet the entire brush. What you do is, you only wet it till here. So you water this portion, only this portion. Then you take a little soap and you can obviously, you know, just swirl it around your hand to get the product off. Again, wash the brush, but again in the same way, only this much. You do not let the water come around this area where the main glue is. So you do it only this much. Then you dry off the brush this way. So you don't do this, or you don't just let it go like that. You give it the shape. You take the excess and you give it the shape. But when you are taking away the excess, do not pull it. Just press. No pulling it. So you take off the excess water and then you dry it on a surface again, putting it standing halfway like that. So this is your surface and the brush stays out like that. So nothing goes near the glue area, which is the perfect way to wash your brushes. I guided you with how to use them, when to use them, the first 5 products or the elaborated kit, and how to clean them. So this was all about brushes. I hope you guys like this video. If you did, please share with your friends. Comment down below if you really love it, if you want me to make more such videos. Thank you so much for watching my video. I'll see you guys next week. Thank you so much.